Okay, so we're going to do this example that talks about cars that are manufactured in the United States. So, what I want to do first is I want to first just write down all of the different probabilities, the likelihood that if I go look at this car, it's made in this country. So, let's start with, it says the United States. So, what percentage of cars in the greater Houston area are manufactured in the United States? 40%. So see how they're writing it as 40%. We're going to work with it in terms of operations. So I'm going to write 0.4. I told you guys on Tuesday that I always work with decimals when I'm doing the work, percentages when I'm writing the answer. Okay? Let's do the next one. Japan. The probability that the car is manufactured in Japan. Should be 0.3, right? It's going to be tough if we're having trouble reading, right? Those are commas. All right, let's try the next one. Is Germany. That one is 10%. It's only the third class, the fourth class, right? Not even halfway. And now, look, at this point, we have 20% in other countries. So I'm going to do that other, O, for 0.2. And I always check when I'm doing problems like this, I always check to make sure that these percentages as decimals add up to 1 or 100%. Let's make sure. All right. So that way we know that it's not inaccurate. All right. There's no mistake happening. Everybody good so far? Okay. So let's look at the first question. What is the likelihood that if you were to pick any car at random from the greater Houston area, right? So millions of cars. That the car is not US made. So the way you can write this is you can write US, all right, but you write a little C up at the top. Does anybody remember from Tuesday what that little tiny C represents? It's the complement, all right? So whenever you're looking for something that's not US or not Germany, right? When you see that word not, that should cue you that this is the complement. So it's going to be 1 minus the likelihood that it's made in the US. Okay? And 1 minus 0.4 is 0.6. So how would I write that as a sentence if I wanted You would write the likelihood that the car I select at random is not made in the US. Is 60%. All right, that's the statement. Yes.
Could you just add up all of
Absolutely. You could have just added up the not US, which should confirm that it's 60%. Yes, Michelle.
Anything else for us?
No, it's not asking you to. So tomorrow on the quiz, you don't have to. I'm just letting you know that the sentence I would write would have a percentage. Any questions on the first one? All right, let's keep going. All right, so it's made in Japan or Germany. All right, now this one, the way I write it is I'm going to write the probability of Japan or Germany. Now, from Tuesday, we're going to use a rule called the addition rule that says that you can add these percentages together. Okay, now that assumes something. What does it assume about these events? Very good, Yareth. You want to give it a go, what that means? She's right. It assumes that these events, a car being made in Germany, a car being made in Japan, are disjoint events. What does that mean?
What happens with the
Perfect, Yareth. So if I find out that this car is made in Japan, what's the likelihood that it was also made in Germany? Zero. It can't. We don't have any cars that are made in multiple countries. I mean, obviously, other countries is a mix. But you're not, it doesn't have like some parts made in Japan, some parts made in Germany. According to this, the whole thing is made in the same country. Everybody good? So that allows us to just add 0.3 plus, bless you, 0.1 to get the answer of 0.4 or 40%. I'll pause here. Anyone have any questions about that? Because you do need to know for the test, the quiz tomorrow, what it means to have disjoint events, disjoint and mutually exclusive events. Same thing. Question, Kathy?
Yeah,
So we're just saying that we have a 40% chance that if I were to pick any card random and go look at it and like turn it over and look at where it's made, you know, like on your clothes. No, I thought that was pretty funny. No one's turning a card. Anyway, it would say made in Japan, and then, or it could say made in Germany. Right? It's not going to say both. That's what the whole point is here. It's not going to say both. It's not going to say made in Japan or Germany. It's just going to say one or the other. But we got a 40% chance it says one or the other. Did that answer that question?
Yeah.
Go.
On the test tomorrow,
is it going to
say
no, it's just going to say something like that, and you need to know, I'm not going to ask you, like, why can you do this, but you need to know why it's okay that you just add them. That's okay to add them when you see the word or.
But, okay, like,
of course, absolutely, but I need you to know that you're assuming these are disjoint events, right, that a car cannot be made in both. Yes?
Is that how you write it?
Absolutely. Yeah, you're all good. Okay, let's do the third one, the last one on this slide. Okay, now it gets a little more challenging. Now we're going to see two cars. All right, the first car we go see is made in Japan. And the second car we see is made in Japan. So that is going to be the probability that you see a car made in Japan and Japan. Now, whenever you see that word and, you should be thinking multiplication. The multiplication rule we talked about on Tuesday. What assumption do we make when we use the multiplication rule? Independence, right? I love it. You're right, Leslie. Independence. Okay, we're saying that if I find out that this car is made in Japan, that does not affect the next car I go look at. Now, technically, we are violating independence. All right, think of it like this. Say you're holding a bag of M&Ms. All right, you're going to imagine I'm holding a bag of M&Ms, like a personal size, nothing crazy. Right, let's say there's 20 M&Ms in it. All right, what are the colors that are in M&Ms? Right? And for my 20, all right, let's say I pull out one that's red. What happens to the likelihood of me pulling out all the colors? No. They change, right? I've got, well, depends, right? The likelihood could change, go up or down, right? But it changes because I've only got 20, all right? And when you only have 20, it's going to change in a big way. But what if I have 20 million M&Ms? If I take on one, it will still change your F, right? But it's so minuscule, it'll be as if it's not changing. It did happen, but it will be as if it didn't change, right? So if we're talking about millions of cars, and I take one out that was made in Japan, what happens to all of these percentages? They change, but it's millions of cars, so the change is so small, we don't even think that it changes. We know it does, but we just assume we're not going to worry about it. That's called independence. Okay? So let's multiply. So we have Japan is 30%. So I have 0.3 times 0.3. All right? And what is 0.3 times
0.3?
Excellent. Thank you. Every year somebody says 0.9, and it makes me a little sad. Yep. I had a feeling. All right, so Saul, what's the likelihood that I'm going to randomly go to two cars and they're both going to be made in Japan?
9%.
Very good, Saul, 9%. So that's not very likely, right? Less than 10%, but it could happen, right? It's not less than 1%. How are we doing so far? Everyone okay? Okay, let's keep going. Three more. Ooh, it's going to be real fun. Okay, the first part's all the same. So we're still going to use all the same decimals and percents. None of these three cars come from Germany. So that's the probability of not Germany and not Germany and not Germany. Well, the first one I go to, not made in Germany. The second one, not made in Germany. And the third one, not made in Germany. So you notice I put these little C's here. What do those C's represent? The complement. Could you write N-O-T-G each time? Right? I get students that write N-O like this. Right? And do it another time. You can do that. That's fine. I don't care. You can write not G. That's fine. All right? I just know my brain knows this C means not Germany. Because it's called the complement. Okay? So what is the likelihood that a car is made in Germany? That it is made in Germany. 0.1. So not Germany, not German made, we 0.9. But we're doing multiplication because you see the word and, so it's going to be 0.9 cubed. And you could write 0.9 times 0.9 times 0.9. But hopefully at this point, you're ready for exponents. So use that calculator if you need it. That's why I told you to grab it. 0.9 cubed. So we have about a 73% chance of this happening. That's fairly likely to happen. Okay? That we're going to find three in a row that are not German made. Questions on that one? Okay, let's do the next one. This is the trickiest one. Okay? So if you're kind of paying attention, really pay attention now. At least one of three cars is U.S. made. The moment I read the words at least, my brain says, oh, be careful. This is a tricky one. Okay, let's think about this. We're looking at three cars, and it says at least one of these three is made in the United States. All right, so what are my options, Wences? If I go up to three cars, what are my options for satisfying this at least one of three? So you imagine I'm walking up to three cars, right? Okay. I want to say, what's the likelihood that at least one of these three is made in the U.S.? So what are my options to satisfy that inequality? No, you're thinking too hard. I'm just asking. All of them. There we go. That's good, right? Three out of three. Does that satisfy at least one? Yes, three is more than one. What's another one that would satisfy it? Two out of three. Right? Wouldn't two out of three also satisfy at least one out of three? And what's the other one? One out of three would also satisfy. That was what I'm going for. Good now?
Yeah.
All good. Sorry to call you. All right. Now, what's the only one that I didn't write up there because it will not satisfy? Zero, right? So in my brain, when I see the word at least, I'm going to find the complement of at least one out of three. The complement of one out of three, or at least one out of three, is none out of three. So right now, with me, I'd like for you to find the probability that I get none U.S. out of three. So what am I going to write for not U.S., not U.S., and not U.S.? Right, so you would write USC, USC, USC. Boo, hate that college. So you'd write points. Excuse me, 0.6 cubed. I want to make sure everyone's still with me. Does everyone see why I wrote 0.6? Because it's not U.S. made, and 40% is U.S. So not U.S. would be 0.6. And I want three of them, so cubed, 0.6 and 0.6 and 0.6. So what is that? Thank you. So we have about a 20% chance of looking at three cars and none of them being from the U.S. Okay? But is that what it asked me to find? No. I just found the complement of at least one out of three are U.S. made. All right? So to get the probability that at least one out of three are U.S. made, I'm going to do 1 minus 0.216. Because 1 minus its complement will give me the answer. And that's going to be the hardest thing and the most missed question tomorrow. Okay? So when you see the words at least, I'm trying to let your brain know you got two steps to do. Find the complement of at least, and then 1 minus that number. Questions? And don't worry, you're going to practice later. Okay? Let's do the last one. The first car that I see that's made in Japan is the fourth one that I choose. So I go to the first one, not Japan. I go to the second one, not Japan. The third one, not Japan. But the fourth one, Japan. So here we go. The probability of not Japan, and not Japan, and not Japan, and Japan. Now again, if you want to use NOT, that's fine, right? It's all good. All right, so I'm going to write not Japan, which is 0.7. How many not Japanese cars? 3, right? So 0.7 cubed times how many Japanese cars? Just one, right? So 0.3. So if this is the probability that it's made in Japan, this is not Japan. 1 minus 0.3 is 0.7. So we're saying there's 3 of them that are not Japanese made, and then 1 is. Now, if you want to have a little check, I didn't put an exponent here, but that is to the first power. And what is 3 plus 1? Gives you 4, right? So we only have 4 cars here. Why am I multiplying? Because of the word and. Anytime you see the word and, you're going to multiply. Well, you're assuming independence here. Anytime you see the word or, you're going to add. Assuming mutually exclusive events. All right, so what's all that one? What's 0.7 cubed times 0.3? I did not hear that. 0.1103? Excellent. So about a 10% chance of that happening. Okay, so